Let us relax our body and mind and sit firmly with head, neck and back erect. Let us sit quietly for a while. Before we begin our meditation, it is always necessary to sit quietly for a while and start meditation in a relaxed way. Let us offer our salutations to the all-blissful Divine Spirit who pervades everything. Let us also offer our salutations to our spiritual teachers, prophets and incarnations from whom we have inherited all our spiritual treasure. Let us send currents of good thought in every direction, north, east, west, south, above and below. Let us breathe in vibrations of purity. Let us breathe out vibrations of purity. Let us breathe in vibrations of strength. Let us breathe out vibrations of strength. Let us breathe in vibrations of love. Let us breathe out vibrations of love. Let us breathe in vibrations of peace. Let us breathe out vibrations of peace. Let us focus our attention in the sanctuary of our heart and there feel the presence of the Infinite Spirit, the soul of our soul. Now let us reflect or mull over different aspects of divinity, different aspects of reality. Using our creative imagination, let us feel free to use our own imageries, our own imagination, and become absorbed in the Divine Spirit in our own way. Let us dwell on these aspects. Let us dwell on the meaning of these divine attributes. We meditate or become absorbed in our true self. He is the Atman. He is our innermost self, the essence of our being. He is all love. Out of compassion, he destroys the darkness born of ignorance by lighting the lamp of knowledge. He is the supreme purifier. He removes all impurities within. In the form of sin, in the form of karma, in any other form. He is the supreme abode of peace. All manifestations in this universe originate from Him. All attributes of beings arise from Him. Attributes like intelligence, knowledge, forbearance, truth, self-control, calmness, pleasure and pain, birth and death, non-injury, equanimity, contentment, austerity, chastity, charity, fame and opposite of that, all these come from Him only. Even the law of karma functions in the relative world through His power. Otherwise, it is dull and non-existent. He alone manifests as sun, moon, stars and planets, fire, air, water, trees, birds and animals, God, demons, human beings, devotees of God, all glory, beauty, splendor, memory, intelligence, forgiveness, victory, goodness of good people, all have come from Him only. He is the center and circumference of everything. Moving and non-moving. He is in everything and everything is in Him. He is the benign, creative power. As well as the cosmic power of destruction. He is time. He is death. Just as the rivers rush towards the sea, all manifestations, all beings, animate and inanimate, they are all rushing towards death. He devours everything. He is terrible. One who takes refuge in him is not afraid. Fearlessly, he sees both aspects of the divine, sublime and terrible. One who takes refuge in him receives his grace. such a devotee, such a spiritual seeker, is all loving. He does work as his worship. He realizes the Supreme Spirit in this life and in this body.
Om Shanti 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 Om.